22nd of November 1963. For President John F. Kennedy and those who attended the presidential motorcade, it was a seemingly ordinary day. However, just a few hours later, a plot would unfold that would leave the American president dead in the orchestration of one of the most notorious murders in history. The location? Dallas, Texas. The president was visiting in order to resolve a conflict that had arisen in the Democratic Party. It was clear that those around him were apprehensive, as this was a city known for its right-wing extremism. However, ironically, his supposed killer, Lee Harvey Oswald, was a leftist radical who is said to have opposed the president's Cuban policies. There were more than 300 Dallas policemen, 40 state policemen, and more than a dozen county deputy sheriffs were designed to protect the president. Despite all of these precautions, the tragedy of the day could not be stopped. The events of the day went as follows. The president, his wife Jackie Kennedy plus Governor John Colony, and his wife Nellie were driven along Delhi Plaza. A large crowd of spectators had gathered. The journey began smoothly, with the president smiling out at the crowd. The fears and anxieties of the day seemed to disappear. However, by 12:30 p.m., less than an hour after the motorcade set off, a shot rang out. The first of three that would ultimately end the life of the president. Secret Service agents rushed to his aid, but it was immediately clear that the inflicted headshot wound would result in his death. JFK was rushed to the hospital and pronounced dead at 1 p.m. Kennedy's vice president, Lyndon B. Johnson, was officially sworn in not long after, aboard Air Force One. This led to the iconic photograph, with the former First Lady stood beside Johnson, still covered in her husband's blood. This is just one of the iconic images associated with the day. It seems even those not present at the assassination have a clear visual memory of the tragedy. The open-top Lincoln Continental car and Jackie Kennedy's pink Chanel suit will forever be associated with this tragic event and strengthen its place in historical memory. Since his death, John F. Kennedy has been immortalized in the public memory. By 1963, he had been president for just 2 years, having been inaugurated in 1961. But despite this, he remains one of the most talked-about presidents in history. Many would argue this was due to the controversial and sudden nature of his death, but Kennedy's charm and his association with many of the big events of this decade certainly helped. Whether you agree with his policies or not, Kennedy played a crucial role in elements of the civil rights movement, the Vietnam War, and in the Cold War, including the Cuban Missile Crisis that will not be forgotten. He has been remembered by many as a great statesman and a good leader that was taken too soon. Questions surrounding Kennedy's death began to rise as years went on, with many feeling that the details surrounding the assassination did not add up, and many believing that the government was somehow involved. In fact, by 1967, belief in the conspiracy had risen to 64%. There were dozens of these theories, some with substantial evidence and some with very little. What prevails, though, is the general consensus that the American people do not believe the official government story of the death of the 35th president. The number of shooters and bullets were widely disputed, as the idea that any lone gunman or even multiple would have been able to harm the president that day, considering the security forces present. For example, John McAdams, an American professor of political science, writes that there are 68 people either accused or that have confessed to the murder of John F. Kennedy. So whilst many people still dispute the identity of the president's killer, large amounts of evidence point towards it having been Lee Harvey Oswald, the ex-Marine and Marxist, paid the ultimate price. Firstly, by being arrested and then being fatally shot by Jack Ruby live on television just 2 days after the assassination. But whether he acted alone or on behalf of the government is yet another point of contention. One particular theory goes that Oswald was tied to a communist ring in the CIA, and therefore the assassination was a retaliation for the Bay of Pigs campaign, which sought to remove Cuban leader Fidel Castro. Another states that because of his continuing turn from nuclear war toward the vision of peace, he was executed by the powers that be. All of these theories have strengths in their own right, but as of yet, no conspiracy has been proven. This truly was an event that not only shocked America, but the whole world, It brought political violence into the minds of the American people and cut short of the life of one of America's most beloved presidents. It is certainly an infamous moment in history, immortalized and captured on film. What is obvious is that despite divided opinions on Kennedy, this marked moment is one that shocked the nation, and it is clear we are still looking for answers today.